Are you currently creating or building a solopreneur business? Perhaps you've been feeling kind of frazzled and frustrated in figuring out the right steps to take to really grow your business to the next level as a solopreneur. Well, in this video today, I'm going to be sharing with you the 6 stages of a solopreneur business so that you can diagnose which stage you're in, what objectives are you supposed to be focusing on each stage, and the right actions to take to grow you to the next level as a solopreneur. I'll also be sharing how you can thrive in each of these stages from my own personal story and experience and really succeed as a solopreneur. Escape the 9-to-5 and create your path to freedom. Hey, thank you so very much for being here. I am Lydia Lee. I'm a work and reinvention strategist, and I help passionate individuals to reinvent their work to create a meaningful business that can support the life that they really want. So if you're new here, welcome to the channel, and don't forget to hit the subscribe and notification bell button so that you'll be the first to know every single video that I release here on the channel every week, and you can be part of the community, the growing community that's here. And of course, if you enjoyed this video today, don't forget to share it. Now, I want to talk a little bit about solopreneurship businesses today and the stages and what to expect in each stage so that you can thrive and feel successful as a solopreneur. Now, if you're unsure what a solopreneur really is, it's really quite simple. It's someone that's very likely a one-man or one-woman show, but it doesn't mean that they work alone. It means that they have a very simplified business model that very likely delivers a premium or one-to-one type of product. You could potentially also offer courses and other sorts of service-based business services, but very likely you want to keep your business small strategically, right? And if you're really interested in knowing what I've really benefited in being a solopreneur in the many years that I've been a business owner, just right on top of this video, I'll be sharing with you a link to really watch that video that I made last week about the benefits that I've learned being a solopreneur that's given me the lifestyle freedom that I really want in my life. Now, starting as a solopreneur is always a great, excellent model to go with because it is simplified, nothing complicated, and very likely you might want to stick with a model like this in order to actually have a life and actually feel that you don't have to do too many things to succeed in your business. Now, if you're built and designed like me, I value freedom and I value flexibility and time. So being able to stay small strategically as a solopreneur has allowed me to earn the income that I want to make choices in my business that allows me to stay solo, and be able to still scale my time and my efforts and my productivity in doing certain things like outsourcing some work when I need to, working with very high expertise contractors that I don't have to manage that will support me in my business, and even creating partnerships with other people. But primarily, I like being small, I like being in charge, and I like being actually the person that people hire and work with intimately. So as I've gone through also 7 full years of being a solopreneur, really, I've learned a lot along the way, and I've really managed to summarize, which I'm going to explain to you in today's video, the 6 sort of major stages of being a solopreneur, just so that you can diagnose where you're at in the solopreneur journey and know that what you're, the things you should be focusing on should be aligned with the stages that you're currently in, right? So that you're not doing things that aren't really appropriate for what you need to accomplish at the stage you're in, and you're making sure that your time, your effort, right, your money, everything is really focused on really in a way upgrading yourself from one stage to the next without stretching yourself too thin to be doing activities that aren't meant at the stage that you're in as a solopreneur. All right, so let's start with stage 1. Stage 1 is what I call the dreaming stage. So stage 1 is basically you are just aspiring to start a business and you're a bit curious to work for yourself, but you may not know what it is that you want to do just yet. Don't worry, this is part of the solopreneurship journey, and part of this stage of the journey is really to focus on how you can commit to getting yourself ready for that transition from being an employee to an entrepreneur. Okay, so instead of thinking at this point about what model you might be working on or what services you might be creating, just start at this place of a pause that's going to just have you acting on this personal readiness that I think you need to prepare before you actually start to tackle other things in the solopreneur journey. So really think about, why do you want to work for yourself, right? This is sort of where we ground ourselves in the intention to be a solopreneur and really ask ourselves, why do I want to work for myself? Why does this particular model interest me? You know, are there parts of the way I want to work, you know, and how I want to design my days as someone who does work, right? Is what sort of important elements are really important for me to remember that are really true to the values of how I want to work, but also the values of how I want to live my life. Now, to be honest with you, sometimes even though I'm, you know, levels beyond the beginning journey of a solopreneur, I sometimes come back to this question of like, why am I doing what I'm doing? Because it aligns me back to particular decisions that I want to make in my solopreneurship business. So you want to figure out your motivation. What's really driving you to commit to learning more to be a solopreneur, to be a business owner, to want to work for yourself? And the secondary thing that's most important here is really preparing your life in the sense of, I would believe, the financial preparation and the conversations that you really need to be having, potentially with your spouse, with your family, with the people close around to you, that this is something that you're desiring to do so they can support you. But finances is a big one. You know, when we think about jumping ship from working for someone else to working for ourselves, one of the biggest urgent, you know, sort of panic moments that we have is like, oh God, how do I replace my income? What do I really need, right, to support myself in the life that I want to have? And to be honest, most people aren't quite sure of this number. And so when we understand what is enough for the lifestyle choices we want, to take care of our families, to save for the future, to travel if we want to, when you know the right number to be reaching for, then that's going to create a boost to the motivation and drive, right, to be a solopreneur and to work for yourself. And that's something that you can remember, that there's a real number associated with your goals, right? And that's going to help you to really develop the kind of services that helps you reach that revenue goal in due time. Now, if you're unsure what those numbers are, right on top of this video, I'm going to be connecting you with a free sort of financial spreadsheet that I've made. Spreadsheet sounds really formal. Yes, it is a spreadsheet, but it's really simple. And it really helps you to just sort of understand your numbers and understand what it is that you really need to live the life that you want and what sorts of money that's going out right now for your life, and thinking about sort of negotiable and non-negotiable expenses to keep that enough number as low as possible, so it's a little easier for you to reach. Okay, you can download that as a freebie from me to you. All right, stage two of the solopreneur journey is the ideation stage, right? Where you are needing a business idea, you're thinking a little bit, yep, I've decided I want to work for myself, I'm past stage one of the motivation and drive to do this, I'm committed to this, but I'm not quite sure what I would do as a service. What kind of business idea do I really have? I might have multiple ideas and I haven't been able to choose one, right? And the important part here is to really start to focus and pick a niche that you actually really want to be designing a business around, right? You need a business idea and a niche that you can work in. So the focus for this stage really is to actually figure out not what ideas are out there and available for solopreneurs, but a more personal approach, which is actually taking inventory of your work experience, taking stock of what you enjoy doing, what skill sets do you want to actually evolve from your corporate career, perhaps, if you've been, you know, working in a particular industry for many, many years, and really thinking a lot about what all your work experience has brought you to realize that is more purposeful for you to earn a living from these days, right? A lot of times when I've been working with people who have been in 15, 20 year careers, it can be confusing to go, do I keep doing what I used to do? I kind of know too much, and what can I really focus on? So part of that is sometimes getting some mentorship to kind of see the forest from the trees. But if you were to do this on your own, it's really to really take stock, right? Take a look at every job you've had, especially the ones that have meant something to you, and really pick out and choose the aspects of those jobs that really called to you, or you were really excellent at, or you really felt meaningful to do. You don't want to do the things that you only know how to do but don't really care about anymore. You want to really focus on things that you enjoy doing that are meaningful for you and perhaps, you know, has an impact towards a cause that you really believe in, right? And so that's really important in an idea, right? Something meaningful and valuable, not just for people to buy, but for something that you're really excited to share and deliver. Moving on to stage three, which is the validation stage. This is sort of where you want to feel confident about the business focus that you've chosen to pursue. So you're still potentially feeling a little bit wavered on, okay, should I be going here or there? But you've kind of chosen a path that you want to explore and you want to kind of see if that is the right path for you to start putting time, energy, and money into. So the objective here is really feeling confident in that there is a market for the potential service that you might choose to provide. So the action to really focus on here is to, I would suggest to really focus on one audience member, right? One type of customer that's best suited for your idea. Now, I know it's going to be tempting as a new business owner to try to serve everybody and be everything to everyone, but that is one of the biggest traps in actually going nowhere in terms of traction for a solopreneur business or any business for that matter. When you actually laser focus on one type of customer and you get real curious on how to help them, you are really going to be able to understand how to serve them and what sort of solutions you need to create for them in your services. So, in this stage, a big focus is going to be market research, right? You're going to actually start talking, not just scouring the internet and researching blogs and articles. Here's where I suggest to actually conduct a market research campaign where you're talking to real humans about their problems. So you might want to choose the kind of person you're best to help. Now, thinking about who are these like-minded people, who are these soulmate clients that you might want to actually be supporting and helping your services, you may not have to look very far than what's familiar to you. A soulmate customer is very likely someone that's like-minded as you, similar values as you, and perhaps have gone through what you've gone through, especially if you're someone that's doing a business that solves a problem or solved a problem for yourself where you're experienced in doing and offering that service for other people. So very likely is an avatar of a customer that is kind of like you and very similar as you are as an individual. Secondarily, you could even look at customers as who you've been familiar helping. Maybe you've been in the corporate industry where you're very familiar with a particular niche of an audience that you just know, like really deeply how to help them and what they've already gone through. And perhaps you already have access to some of these really cool customers where you'd have to look very far to get your first few customers or be able to call them up and research a bit on what their problems really are. So get real curious on how to help, right? A primary type of audience, picking one type of person to help, talking to real humans about their problems and starting to, right, diagnose where you can really support them. And as these ideas emerge, you might be starting to document some of these solutions that you would love to provide to help them with those types of problems. And at this point, you might want to think about for the future that you want to maybe reserve some of these people that you've been interviewing as beta clients for the future, because these are the best sort of beta clients to test out your concepts, test out your sort of inaugural service that can really help build credibility and testimonials for when you're ready to really launch your business. Stage four is the business plan or planning stage for a solopreneur. This is where you really want a clear plan on how you'll achieve your financial goals with your business. Now, here's sort of where the objective that I think you should really be focusing on is be really ultra clear on your niche. Now, your niche is not just about who you're solving it for, your soulmate customers, but your niche, the one of the easiest ways to really get clear in your niche is really focusing on a core problem for that one particular customer, right? Now, knowing your customer, which you've done in stage three, right, really in the validation of finding that one person to serve, now you can start to really think about in your business plan and in clarifying your niche at this stage is where's your best customers hanging out and where you can find them. Now, very likely this could be different for different people. You want to look in the access of what's available to you already. If you're part of associations, organizations, you have membership somewhere, you have LinkedIn, where you have access to some of these people, this is sort of the best place to start thinking about where you can make sure to structure a strategy to attract those customers in your plan. Now, the focus here, as I said, is really thinking about solving one core problem so that you're really known in the expertise that you want to be known for, but also it's easy for people to choose you, where you're not doing everything under the moon, you're not promising to do every single step all the problems that you can solve, but you're really choosing one core problem that you're best suited to solve that your audience needs urgently. So if you remember doing those interviews in stage three, as you document what those problems are, you can start to really see what repeated patterns of problems may come in fruition from your interviews, right? And on an instinctive level, you can think about what excites you most and what's most meaningful for you to help bring solutions for that isn't the full shebang, but something very, very focused and one core problem that you can really offer. All right, stage five, we're almost there, guys. Stage five of the solopreneurship journey is launching, right? So you're in this particular stage is if you're ready to start selling your services and finding leads for your business. So you're ready with an offer, right? You're really clear on, or you're ready to know what your service may be anyway, right? And you're ready to really start designing a model to sell your services effectively. So the objective that I would recommend here for you to focus on is really actually understanding and designing a framework and a signature process for how you deliver and offer your services. Now, you might think that launch includes things like marketing. And yes, it does in a lot of ways, but when you can focus on how you have a particular process of concepts, philosophies, and a really unique framework for why people are hiring you and the process you really take with them to get them to results, guess what? It's going to be a heck easier to market your services when you're really clear on the framework of your offer. So the focus here is to figure out the best design a framework and a signature service, right? That's going to have structure, not just charging by hour or not just charging by, you know, like some of the sort of easy packages, right? It's like X amount of calls with me, and this is what I'm valuing my coaching program as, or whatever editing program or whatever it is that you might be doing, but really thinking about selling an experience, right? Selling something that's packaged and easy to buy. It is premium, it is high quality, and people really understand the what they're paying for, and that's going to actually make you feel confident in really being able to launch and sell your services effectively. The second focus is to figure out the best way of influence and connection that you want to how you want to market with your natural abilities. So what this really means is that we want to obviously have a marketing plan as part of your launch plan, but we want to also be doing it in a way that just feels authentic to you. That's something that you can be consistent doing every single week or every single day for your business that is in alignment with your way of communication and your way of influence. Now, I can't stress that enough, that not to pick so many things that you want to do to market, but really to pick things that you're better at doing. So for example, I love to teach, and I do a lot of my marketing through teaching, whether it's through this channel and video or through webinars. And I use that very specifically to be a lead generator as part of my coaching program. I don't focus as much on writing blogs. I don't focus as much on maybe even pitching to media or journalists as much, because this is where I do best and this is where I best shine, and I get excited to do videos for you guys rather than write another blog, right? So don't forget to really choose marketing activities at the launch stage that really fits your personality and your opportunities, right? Those could be very different for every different business owner. Lastly is stage six, maintaining stability. Okay, so by this point, you might have already have some clients under your belt. You're looking to fill your roster to make sure that you have full-time hours or whatever hours that best suits the revenue model that you are looking to achieve, right, in your business. But your objective really here is to fill to your capacity, right, whatever that means to you. Be really productive and effective in the way that you do your work so that you can deliver exceptional customer service and therefore getting amazing results and hopefully referrals, right? Credibility, right? All those things will come back to you in order to keep you stable as a solopreneur and earning an income consistently every single month to fund your life and your business. So the focus here really is to put the right systems in place to scale your time and really create high quality experiences that you don't have to kind of do manually over and over again. Now, as solopreneurs, we are we are the asset of the company. We are the ones providing the service very likely directly to our customers. So at this point, you know a lot about working with several customers, some of the processes that repeat, right? Some of the things of onboarding clients or making sure they do their work or reviews or whatever it is that you might do as part of your offer, you want to start creating systems that can really help you to not do everything manually every single time, right? So really think about tools, software, automation where it counts, maybe, that can really help you to just spend time doing the work that you love in your business and not the other things that tend to suck a lot of your time, right? And so that will be really, really huge for you to really scale back, right? Where you can really simplify things in your work and make it not only an exceptional service for your clients, right? Really know where you can provide high quality, high touch part of your services, but some of the things that really don't require you to be involved, where a particular software or a tool or even an additional assistant, right, or someone you can outsource that to, that might allow you, again, to gain more time to actually work on the things that you really love. And so in this stage of stability, it's really important to really think about how you can keep your schedule filled with clients, right? So this is where you may start thinking about what are the best marketing efforts that I have already been proven that works, and how can I double down on those marketing efforts and simplify how I market, right? So I get that consistent lead generation to stabilize my income, and really to analyze, right, all the things that you've started doing from the launch stage in stage five, like what are the things that should need to be eliminated from your time, and what are some things, as I said, to double down on. And when you can do that and really focus here on the right effective things to be productive and effective in your work and bring in the leads consistently, then you're going to create that stability in the stage of a solopreneurship business. All right, so we covered a lot today in detail about each part of the six stages of solopreneurship. And these are the things that I've spent lots of time doing in each stage as well in my business to succeed and thrive in all these stages. Now, do you have any questions for me in any of these stages? If you do, do pop it in the comment below. Okay. Thank you so very much for joining me. And again, everything that I film here is for you. So I'm always open to feedback and questions and topics that you may want to suggest for me to film for future videos. So leave me a comment. Let me know if you enjoyed this video. And don't forget to share with someone that you know will benefit from learning in this today.
Ready to work for yourself but have no idea where to begin? I'll show you how. Learn how to create a self-employment plan with work you can love with the Work Reinvented course. It's time to stop wondering if there's a bigger, more meaningful way to enjoy your life and work. There is.